Hi everyone. Thank you for popping into my channel. Now, this is a quick haul video. I picked it up this week, being the 13th of November 2016. Now, I went to my local cardboard sale, not far away from where I live in South London. And this cardboard sale takes place at a place called Battersea, on a school playground. But for the last couple of weeks, I was too lazy to go out sourcing stuff. I decided to go, and today I went a bit too late. You know, it's about closing time. I went out there, so whatever I managed to pick up, I think I've done quite well. And I'm going to go through them with you now. Here is my usual stuff I normally tend to pick up. Baseball caps. This is Los Angeles, LA. It's not a new era, but, you know, I normally pay £2 for this, but the lady wanted £3, so I just gave in to her. Just said, okay, I'll take it. Because I'm normally going for $12.95. So that was my start of the day. Now, this is quite interesting because I'm trying to move into this sort of old retro cassette and radio. This one's Philips RR333 radio recorder. I just tested out, and believe it or not, it works. There we go, crispy sound.
Age we're in, so I do agree with what you're saying.
Look at this. Listen to it.
But it doesn't excuse what Nigel Farage has done.
The only problem with this is the tip of the antenna is broken, so still you can use it. And the cassette, hopefully, will work. I do have fewer cassettes, you know, musical cassette going back to the 70s, so I'm going to try it on, see if it works. Hopefully it should work. And the next items I picked up. Oh, by the way, I paid £4 for that radio. So I don't know how much I'm going to get. I'm going to look it up. I reckon I'm looking about £30 on that one. Then I picked this PS2 PlayStation driving wheel. Yeah, that I picked that up for £2. I have never sold one of these, so I'll have to see how I go along there. And the next one I picked up is this Ninja Turtle plush toy. And the same time, the same lady was selling, let's get this here. She was selling this Darth Vader. Let's put it back in here because it's very difficult to make him stand up. Darth Vader plus, well, it's like a toy or let me press a button, see if I think it works.
I am your father.
He does all his usual growling and I'm your father. Oh, yeah, great. So he works. Now here, on a different stall, this guy was just about to close up, and I've noticed he's got some of these same theme again, Star Wars figures. And he showed, because I never picked these up, and I need to do a little research on this. He said to me they are a radio and a motorized, and it works. But because I didn't have any battery, so I couldn't test them out. So look at how dirty they are. So I need to do a lot of hard cleaning job to get them sparkling and put some batteries in to see if they work. And I did look around and I managed to see they probably used to have charging sockets, but none of them have charging socket with it. So we have Huygongjin there, and Dart Mold. I don't even know how much they go for. And Obi-Wan Kenobi there. For those three, I paid, the guy wanted £5 each, and I said, look, I'm not sure if they're going to work or not work, and I told them, I told the truth, I was a reseller, look, I need to make a bit of profit on those. So he said, okay, you can have them for 10 quid. So three, I paid 3 quid for the 10 of, £10 for the three. So that was, I think that was a good buy. So I don't know how much they're selling for, so I'd have to look around. The next item I picked up, I'm, you know, all these last 20 odd years or so, I've been using one of these phones at home, so I'm sort of used to it. When I saw this BT cordless telephone, I just grabbed it, any, no question asked, because I'm using one at the moment, and I thought, no, I must have it. The lady wanted 10 quid, I said, no. So I end up giving her 6 quid, so if I were to flog it, I'm probably looking at 25, 30 quid on that one. Now, this is quite interesting. I have here a 56K V92/V.90 modem for Windows, Macintosh, and Linux computers. Now, this is actually brand new on a box from Currys. Now, not been taken out of the wrapping or anything like this. It's brand new. So I paid 3 quid for it, and again, I never sold this, so I don't even know what to expect on that one. So I'm thinking about 15, 16 quid, something like original that. Okay, now ladies and gentlemen, this is very interesting. Now, these are called 8-track, the old 8-track, like a cassette, years ago cassette. All right, and look, inside they have a magnetic tape, and you sort of, you have a unit, playing unit, and stick it in, you play music. Now that's going back a bit. And this one here is little touch of Smileyson in the night. RCA Stereo 8, look at that. Yeah. What it does it here? Let's look at them. Little Touch of the Night, Lazy Moon for Me and My Girl. It had to be you. So I'm gonna look into this because I haven't got a clue how much they're going for. There's another one here. It's called Melanie Gatbar. I think GATBR and me. So Melmi. Again, it's not in great condition, you know, because it's sort of retro and I need to clean it up. I don't know, I'm not sure if they work or not work. So who is buying it, they have to buy as it is, and probably a collector's item, I guess, you know, it's for mainly for collector's item. Pink Floyd, Autumn Heart Mothers. Is it Autumn Heart Mother? Yeah, Autumn Heart Mother, Pink Floyd. Again, program one, program two, sorry, let's, right, okay. Lovely. I know they're in a sort of messy state. Slyly and the Family Stone Fresh. Again, all the magnetic tapes are intact. Not lost much damage to it, so all I need to do is clean them up. This one, Lo and Behold, Dennis Coulson, Dixie Dean, Hugh Hint, Tom McGinnis, yeah. Alright, condition, very good this one. Again, bit of cleaning to do. And this one, Hand Clapping, Foot Stamping, Funky Butt Live. There we are, ladies and gentlemen. Duplicated by Ready Fission Limited. Wow, that's going back a bit. I'm sure this is nostalgic thing going on here. If you're into this sort of thing, ladies and gentlemen, grab it. Because you're looking at a piece of history here. So that's about it for this week's video haul. Thank you very much for watching this video and all of my other videos. Please click the like button, subscribe button, smash the like button. And I will leave a link to my new website. It's called Make Money Online Blog. You can check it out. You can also check it out my cooking channel called Indian Restaurant Cooking. And I have another channel, my personal channel. I leave link to it and you can check them out. Please make sure, look, in my Indian cooking channel, I have almost 10,000 subscribers. And in this new channel of mine, I hardly have one yet. So I need to smash that like button, subscribe button. Please, please, please smash the like button and subscribe button, please. I need your help. Now I'm starting this vlog channel where I will go in depth and tell you all about eBay selling. Because I've been doing this for a very, very long time. Although I never stopped doing it over a couple of years. I left it, then I came back recently again. But I started selling on eBay back in 2005 when things were very difficult then and now. So you can imagine 2005, it was a total bit different ball game selling. And I used to sell these sort of antique online those days. So I'm a kind of hard old nutcase, I guess, in the terms of eBay selling. But recently, you know, this is getting good and it's working. And hopefully I will show you everything that I know, what I'm learning as I go along. I will try to teach you if you're willing to learn. And I will tell you ins and out exactly how things happen. So please make sure you subscribe, like, click button and go and support me on my website. makemoneyonlineblog.co.uk, or I'm starting changing my shop name. It will be called eBay World. You can check it out, my store name. I'm going to change it soon to eBay World, so please log in and check me out. Thank you so much indeed, and thank you for watching this video, and thank you for supporting me.